Hi everyone, I am Patrick Cardo. I am a Security Technical Solution Architect at Cisco, and I'm going to walk you through a SecureX demonstration that is about how to automatically update security rules in firewalls from Apache logs and basically from any kind of logs. This is a very good example about how SecureX can ease my life in my day-to-day job. What we are going to do, we are going to create a process, an automation process, that first collect from the network the list of malicious IP addresses from bad activity from bad guys. And we are going to store it into a feed. And this feed, we are going to expose it to any, to be consumed by any relevant security devices. And it will be the second step. Deploy this list in every firewall into the network, but not only, maybe in other security solution. And we want to be informed into a Webex team room that this process occurred. So we are going to use SecureX for doing that. We are going to use two separate processes. The first one will be dedicated to malicious IP address collections. And we will have on the right all our firewalls deployed into the network. And what we are going to do thanks to this process is to, on the left, the collection process will periodically collect from source of trust and actually sensors. The IP addresses of all bad guys, the old guys who had a malicious activity within the network. And all these IP addresses will be stored into a central location that will be the feeds we want to expose to our firewall. A flag will be put up in order to inform all firewall that updates have to be downloaded. And all firewall will be able to download this new IP blocking list and translate it into blocking rules. And we are going to use a SecureX workflow for doing that. We are going to use separate SecureX workflow that will run in parallel, separately. All these workflow are loops. The collection workflow on the left will run every hour, and on the right, we have one workflow per security solution, and all this workflow will run every 5 minutes. They will check if there is an update to download, and if the answer is yes, the process will occur, the update will occur. Let's talk about the sensor now. We are going to use a honeypot, a web server for doing that. This web server is going to be exposed on the internet, and when you do that, it lasts less than 4 hours for the server to be discovered by bad guys, and you will start to see connection from the outside from people who try to hack your web server. And this is very easy to monitor. You can do that with a Webex team bot into your Webex your web server. This is what I did here, and I set it up this. Webex bot. I'm the only one to know it, and if anyone else than me connect to it, definitely this is someone who scanned my web server, and I can confirm into the Apache log that some guys, outside guys, are bad guys because they try to hack my web server. They try to, for example, in this example on the screen, we see that. This guy tried to hack my MySQL database. So definitely, I know that this is a bad guys, and this Apache log is very easy to parse because it has a CSV format. The separator character is the space, and if we parse it, we have in the first column the IP addresses of all people connected to the web server. And we have some information like where the user, the external outside user, try to go into the web server. And from this information, it is very easy to understand that the IP address is malicious. So what we want to do? We want SecureX every hours to collect these Apache logs, and we want SecureX to extract from it any all the IP address of any malicious guys who tried to hack my web server in the last hour, and we want to expose all these IP address into a feed. This feed will be exposed to be consumed by any security solution that need it. And we want to deploy it in all of our firewall, whatever the number they are, whatever vendor, the vendor they are from. We just want to be protected everywhere. So let's have a look to the demonstration. The starting point is the alert we have in the Webex team room. We see in real time that people try to get access to the web server. And if we go to the SecureX private intelligence and the judgment part, the judgment database, this is the location where I want to store all the malicious IP addresses. And I'm going to do this thanks to a workflow. Let's jump into the workflow, SecureX workflow part. I created a workflow called Apache Log Checks. That is very straightforward. There is something like 12 activities. The first one is a timestamp. I want to keep the log to read the Apache log from the last day and not all the Apache logs. And this is the goal of these two steps. Next steps will be to connect to SecureX Judgment Private Intelligence in order to collect the existing IP blocking list. The goal of that is to avoid later to add duplicate entries into this judgment list. And following step will be to connect to the web server, and this is an SSH collection. And we use a CLI command in order to get the Apache logs, and these Apache logs within SecureX will be parsed thanks to a Python script, Python activity. That is, which is very, very simple, very straightforward. And after that, if the IP malicious IP list from Apache logs is not empty, we move forward. We move forward. If this list is empty, we stop here. That means that there are no new malicious IP address to be ingested. But if this list is not empty, we move forward. We create a table within SecureX, and in this loop, we will go through any items, every item within this loop, and we will add all of them into the judgment private intelligence. The last operation will be to calculate the flag, and this is a timestamp. It will be this timestamp that will be checked by security solution workflow, SecureX workflow, in order to understand that there are updates to be downloaded. The last step will be to send Webex team into Webex team room a message to the administrator, telling him that an update had been done in these fields. So let's run this workflow. Let's run in. So it starts. It will last less than 30 seconds. It will be very, very fast. And as you can see, all the steps are executed, and we have the result in the Webex team room. We are informed that update had been added. Let's have a look to the result. And in the judgment private intelligence, now we can see that all the malicious IP addresses had been added. And what we can understand, thanks to the red circle we see on the right of every IP addresses, is that all these red circles flagged IP addresses are known by Cisco Talos as malicious. This red circle is displayed thanks to the information that Cisco Talos has about these IP addresses. So, next step will be to deploy all this into the firewall. Let's have a look to this. And I've got, as an example, an EASY and a Firepower. And I've got this object group location that is empty. And what I want to do is to add all these IP addresses into this object group in order to block them. We are going to use another workflow for doing that. That one will run every 5 minutes. And here it is. This one is very, very simple. The first two steps will be checking the flag to understand that we have update to apply on the firewalls, And if yes, we inform the administrator, thanks to a WebXT message, that he has to update the firewall. So let's run it. We have the result of this, and yes, we have some update to deploy. We can confirm that we want this deployment thanks to this link, and I have inserted an approval workflow into this workflow. This one is protected by a duo multi-factor authentication in order to be sure that no load granted administrator will do that. So let's send a push to the telephone, and let me send my telephone and click on the approve button, and here it is. And now the update process start. It will last a few seconds in order to make this happen, and as we can see, the result will be to add into the network object group all the new IP addresses. In the bot, I can check which update had been created. And here it is, this firewall is updated. Any other firewall will be updated with these new IP addresses to block in the same way. And we have an example with FDM Firepower device. The network object list is empty, and if I update it, refresh it, now I can see that all the objects from the SecureX feed, judgment feeds, had been added. And here it is. So it was very, very fast to do. We can have a lot of firewall within the network from different vendors, and it will work the same as we saw. And thanks to this workflow, I was able to detect a malicious activity in one location, and after that, block it everywhere. So thank you for watching. Don't hesitate to subscribe to this YouTube channel. I hope to see you in a future video on SecureX workflow, and I wish you a very good day.